So for women, it would depend on whether or not they're planning on getting pregnant or are pregnant. If a woman is planning on getting pregnant, the concern is that the Zika virus could be transmitted and could affect the baby, which is essentially the same risk as if you are pregnant. The Zika virus has been associated with birth defects. The term that people have used is microcephaly, which means an unusually small head. And with that comes long-term developmental delays in the baby. It's also been shown to potentially cause some other brain abnormalities. So in any event, it's basically a complication that really has profound effects on the baby for the remainder of his or her life. Couples who are trying to conceive would be the people who are most at risk. So women who are pregnant, women who are thinking of getting pregnant, and their partners all have the potential of transmitting the virus to the fetus. If a partner has gone to an endemic area, if it's a male partner, then we recommend that they use a condom for the remainder of the partner's pregnancy. And if it's a female, then we recommend that she talk to her healthcare provider. And it would usually entail having testing to see if she was exposed, as well as ultrasounds to look at the baby's growth, and in particular looking at the baby's head size over time. The most important thing is that you try and avoid being bit by mosquitoes, and this would go for pregnant women and their partners, as well as a couple that's trying to conceive, is that they need to protect themselves from mosquito bites. So using products that have DEET, which is safe to use in pregnancy, would be very important. Wearing long-sleeved shirts, long pants that can be embedded with permethrin would be the way in which you could prevent trying to be bitten by mosquitoes.